Dear students, in this class we are going to see the concept of Brewster angle, which is defined in parallel polarization or vertical polarization. Whenever the wave is reflected by a perfect dielectric at oblique incidence, and in the last class already we have derived the reflection coefficient for the case of parallel polarization. And once you know this reflection coefficient, then I can tell you the significance of the Brewster angle. So the reflection coefficient ER by EI is equal to root epsilon 2 cos theta 1 minus root epsilon 1 into cos theta 2 divided by root epsilon 2 into cos theta 1 plus root epsilon 1 into cos theta 2. Here you know this theta 1 and theta 2 are nothing but the angle of reflection and as well as angle of transmission, that means angle of refraction. So in this one, and I would like to substitute in the case of cos theta 2, that is equal to root of 1 minus sin square theta 2, sin square theta 2. So this can be written as root epsilon 2 cos theta 1 minus root epsilon 1 into root of 1 minus sin square theta 2 divided by root epsilon 2 cos theta 1 plus root epsilon 1 into root of 1 minus sin square theta 2, sin square theta 2. So you know from the Snell's law is always giving the relation between your angle of incidence as well as angle of reflection. So let me say this is the angle of incidence theta 1, and this is nothing but angle of refraction, this refraction, that is nothing but theta 2. You know the law of sines, or the Snell's law is giving a relation between these two angles, that is nothing but sin theta 1 divided by sin theta 2 is equal to root of epsilon 2 by epsilon 1. So from this I would like to write down the sin square theta 2, because I would like to substitute here. So squaring on both sides, you can have sin square theta 2 is equal to epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 into sin square theta 1. So this is from your Snell's law. So it is also called as law of sines, Snell's law, which is already a well-known law for everybody here. So just to substitute in the place of sin square theta 2, you are going to get here, this is equal to root epsilon 2 cos theta 1 minus root of epsilon 1 into 1 minus sin square theta 2. What is sin square theta 2? Epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 into sin square theta 1 divided by root epsilon 2 cos theta 1 plus root of epsilon 1 into 1 minus epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 into sin square theta 1. Then try to simplify this. This is equal to root epsilon 2 into cos theta 1 minus root of, this is epsilon 1 minus epsilon 1 square by epsilon 2 into sin square theta 1 divided by root epsilon 2 into cos theta 1 plus root of epsilon 1 minus epsilon 1 square by epsilon 2 into sin square theta 1. Okay, so this is equal to, so now this is root epsilon 2 and it will be multiplied with this. This is called epsilon 2. So you can say epsilon 2 cos theta 1 minus, and this may become root of epsilon 1 epsilon 2 minus epsilon 1 square into sine square theta 1 divided by epsilon 2 into cos theta 1 just plus root of epsilon 1 epsilon 2 minus epsilon 1 square into sine square theta 1. You see. Now I would like to divide each and every term by epsilon 1. So I would like to do like this, epsilon 2 by epsilon 1, and here it may become epsilon 1 square, and it may become epsilon 1 square, and this may be by epsilon 1, and it is epsilon 1 square because under the square root epsilon 1 square. So if you do like this, it will be equal to epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 cos theta 1 minus root of, so what is the value of this one? This will be cancelled, and this is also cancelled here. So this is epsilon 1 epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 square, means this is epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 minus sine square theta 1 divided by epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 into cos theta 1 plus root of epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 minus sine square theta 1. So remember friends, all these things are just mathematics. So this is nothing but your ER by EI, that is called reflection coefficient, which is already derived in the last classes, but I am giving in the another format by using your Snell's law. So this is very, very important now. So once you know this reflection coefficient, now I would like to define the most important one, that is nothing but the Brewster angle. So what is the meaning of Brewster angle? Brewster angle is nothing but an angle of incidence at which there is no reflection at all. It is an angle of incidence at which there is no reflection. That means the reflection coefficient must be equal to 0. So if the reflection coefficient is equal to 0, means 0 by anything is equal to 0. That means the numerator should be 0 here. So that's why I would like to use this expression for deriving the Brewster angle. So listen carefully, my dear friends. So I am teaching a lesson to all the students. Andariki paatham cheptunnanu nenu. So some people are actually listening to me, some people are actually leaving me. But how much energy is transmitting to the minds is much more important. That is called a transmission coefficient. How much they are leaving is nothing but reflecting towards me. That means called reflection coefficient. So Brewster angle means it is very much important for each and every teacher to maintain. Ikkada students andaro paatham vintunnappudu ఏ యాంగిల్తో అయితే నేను పాఠం చెబితే వాళ్ళందరికీ అర్థమయ్యి ఏది కూడా రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అవ్వదో దాన్ని బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ అంటారు. బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ మీన్స్ ఇండైరెక్ట్ డిస్టెల్లింగ్ ద రిఫ్లెక్షన్ షుడ్ నాట్ బి దేర్. రిఫ్లెక్షన్ షుడ్ బి 0. రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఫిషియంట్ మస్ట్ బి 0. సో దట్ టు ఇట్ ఈస్ డిఫైన్డ్ ఇన్ విచ్ పోలరైజేషన్? దిస్ పోలరైజేషన్ వెర్టికల్ పోలరైజేషన్. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ప్యారలల్ పోలరైజేషన్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ డిఫైన్డ్ ఇన్ perpendicular polarization, which is horizontal polarization. I told you in the last class also, there are two polarizations we are maintaining daily. One is nothing but horizontal and other one is vertical. Manu active gundi panjeskune time anta, day time anta, we are maintaining vertical polarization. But whereas during the night time, we are maintaining horizontal polarization. So horizontal polarization means indirectly, it is a touching the surface of the conductor, means taking rest. నైట్ ఏం చేస్తాం మనం? హారిజెంటల్ పోలరైజేషన్లో ఉంటాం. వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ రెస్ట్. డ్యూరింగ్ దట్ రెస్ట్ నో బడీ ఈజ్ రెడీ టు లిసన్. దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ యాక్చువల్లీ డిఫైనింగ్ బ్రువస్టర్ యాంగిల్ ఫర్ దట్ పోలరైజేషన్, హారిజెంటల్ పోలరైజేషన్. దట్స్ వై మెలుకుగా ఉన్న వాళ్ళకి లెసన్ చెప్పాలి కాబట్టి. వెర్టికల్ పోలరైజేషన్లో ఉన్న స్టూడెంట్స్కి అంటే యాక్టివ్గా ఉన్నప్పుడు మనం చెప్పేది కాబట్టి దట్ బ్రువస్టర్ యాంగిల్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ డిఫైన్డ్ ఫర్ vertical polarization, which is also called as your parallel polarization. So that's why whatever the angle that is to be maintained by the teacher, that angle is nothing but your Brewster angle. Nijanga teacher kanaka Brewster angle concept telisthe,
ఆ యాంగిల్తో పాఠం చెబితే ప్రతి పిల్లవాడికి కూడా నీట్గా అర్థమవుతుంది తప్ప రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అవ్వదు. దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్. సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్? ఇట్ ఈస్ అన్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ ఎట్ విచ్ దేర్ ఈజ్ నో రిఫ్లెక్షన్ అట్ ఆల్. ప్రతి ఒక్కరికి కూడా ట్రాన్స్మిట్ అయిపోవాలి తప్ప రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అవ్వకూడదు. ఆ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ అవ్వకోకుండా మొత్తం అంతా అర్థం అవ్వడానికి కావలసినటువంటి యాంగిలే నథింగ్ బట్ బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్. సో ఫైనల్లీ దెర్ ఆర్ టూ పాయింట్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్. నెంబర్ వన్, బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ ఇస్ డిఫైన్డ్ ఫర్ వెర్టికల్ పోలరైజేషన్ విచ్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ యువర్ ప్యారలల్ పోలరైజేషన్. అండ్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్ ఈజ్ బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ అట్ విచ్ దేర్ ఈజ్ నో రిఫ్లెక్షన్ అట్ ఆల్. వెరీ సింపుల్, రైట్ డౌన్ ది ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ ఫర్ ది రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ అండ్ మేక్ ఇట్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. దట్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ యువర్ బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్. సో నౌ లెట్ మీ డెరైవ్ దట్ బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్. ఓకే, బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ మీన్స్ జస్ట్ నౌ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ ఇట్ ఈజ్ అన్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ అట్ విచ్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో రిఫ్లెక్షన్. ఏ యాంగిల్ తోటి వేవు కనుక ఇన్సిడెంట్ అయితే రిఫ్లెక్షన్ లేకుండా మొత్తం ట్రాన్స్మిట్ అవుతుందో దాన్ని బ్రవస్టర్ యాంగిల్ అంటారు. దట్స్ వై ఐ హావ్ గివెన్ ఎ డెఫినేషన్ హియర్. ఇట్ ఈస్ అన్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ అట్ విచ్ దేర్ ఈజ్ నో రిఫ్లెక్షన్ అట్ ఆల్. దట్ మీన్స్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. ఈఆర్ బై ఏ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. అండ్ వన్ మోర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఈజ్ హియర్, ఇట్ ఈజ్ డిఫైన్డ్ ఇన్ ప్యారలల్ ఆర్ వెర్టికల్ పోలరైజేషన్. ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ ద రీజన్ ఫర్ డిఫైనింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వెర్టికల్ పోలరైజేషన్ ఆల్సో. సో యు నో ద రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ఫార్ములా. జస్ట్ నౌ వీ హ్యావ్ డెరైవ్డ్ ఇట్. Now, as per the definition of the Brewster angle, this should be equal to zero. When it will be equal to zero? Whenever the numerator is equal to zero. So that's why epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 cos theta 1 minus root of epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 sine minus sine square theta 1 is equal to zero. Then you try to squaring on both sides and then you can say epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 square into cos square theta 1 is equal to epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 into minus sin square theta 1. After squaring on both sides you got this sin square theta 1. So now you can see here cos square theta 1 is nothing but your 1 minus sin square theta 1. So I can write here epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 minus sin square theta 1 is equal to epsilon 2 square by epsilon 1 square into 1 minus sin square theta 1. This is. Now I would like to take this sin square theta 1 to this side. And you are going to get this here. You can say epsilon 2 minus epsilon 1 by epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2 square divided by epsilon 1 square is equal to sine square theta 1 minus epsilon 2 square by epsilon 1 square into sin square theta 1. Okay. So this is equal to epsilon 1 square is nothing but this is, and this will be epsilon 1 into epsilon 2, and this is equal to minus epsilon 2 square is equal to sin square theta 1 into 1 minus epsilon 2 square divided by epsilon 1 square. So this is equal to sin square theta 1 into 1 minus, this is epsilon 1 square minus epsilon 2 square divided by epsilon 1 square. So this and this will be cancelled, epsilon 1 square is. So here epsilon 1 epsilon 2 minus epsilon 2 square is equal to sin square theta 1 into epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 into epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2. That means a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Here you try to take it a common, epsilon 2 into epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2 is equal to sin square theta 1 into epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 into epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2. So you can cancel these two.
therefore sin square theta 1 is equal to epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2. That means sin theta 1 is equal to square root of epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2. So this is nothing but the relation here. Now once you know this sin theta 1, then you can write down the cos theta 1, because cos theta 1 is nothing but cos theta 1 is equal to root of epsilon 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2. This is the formula for cos theta 1. So once you know this sin theta 1 and cos theta 1, and happily you can write down the tan theta 1 also. So what is the tan theta 1? Tan theta is nothing but sin theta by cos theta, that is equal to root of sin theta epsilon 2 divided by epsilon 1. So this is nothing but the tan theta. So this is nothing but this Brewster angle. Here the Brewster angle theta 1 is equal to, you can say angle of incidence is equal to tan inverse root of epsilon 2 by epsilon 1. So this is the angle of Brewster angle. So what I told you, Brewster angle means it is an angle of incidence at which there is no reflection. That it is an angle of incidence only. Here also the theta 1 is nothing but the angle of incidence. So if you send a wave with this angle, definitely there is no question of reflection of energy. Entire energy will be transmitted into the other medium like this. So this is nothing but the Brewster angle. So this is the way of doing the derivation for the Brewster angle. Okay, I hope you understood this. And next we will see what do you mean by the total internal reflection. Okay. So let me discuss the total internal reflection. And I have written the formulas for the reflection coefficient for both polarizations, perpendicular polarization as well as parallel polarization. Here, if epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2, if epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2 in both cases, then sin theta 1 should be greater than epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 in the numerator. So if sin theta 1 is greater than this value, then it becomes a complex value. So the second one is more than the first one, that's why it becoming complex numbers. So finally it will be in the form of a minus jb by some a plus jb, like a complex value. So if you take the magnitude of this, then it becomes 1. That means whenever the medium 1 is more denser than the medium 2, you are having a complex value here. So that means sin theta 1 is greater than epsilon 2 by epsilon 1, then the reflection takes place. And suppose, for example, if you take an interface once again, so let me say these are the two mediums, this is the medium 1 and this is the medium 2. Medium 1 is having the permittivity epsilon 1 and this is epsilon 2. And here our assumption is epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2. That means medium 1 is denser than medium 2. Then if you take this angle of incidence, and something will be transmitted and something will be reflected like this, you know this. So this is angle of incidence theta I, and this is reflection, and this is nothing but the transmission. But whenever you are assuming that epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2, then the wave entirely will be reflected back. So nothing will be transmitted into the medium 2. So that's why at that time the entire wave will be along the surface of this interface like this. So if you see the velocity of this, then the velocity will be less, that is equal to v is equal to omega by beta into beta 2 into root of epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 into sin theta 1, and which is very less compared to the velocity in the second medium, that is nothing but omega by beta 2, because this is nothing but the phase velocity. So if the epsilon 1 is very very greater than the epsilon 2, the entire wave will be reflected and it will be grazing the surface of this boundary like this. That's why
That is called as a surface wave. And the surface wave is having the velocity less than the velocity in the second medium. And one more thing is here, the surface wave is the best example of non-uniform plane wave. But up to now I told you the concept of uniform plane waves. But whenever the epsilon 1 is very, very greater than epsilon 2, nothing will be transmitted, the entire thing will be reflected back, and this is called as the total internal reflection, which is nothing but the surface wave. At that time, I may not say entire thing will be reflected back, something will be transmitted, and that velocity of this wave in the second medium is a slow wave. The velocity is very, very less. So that's why your total internal reflection takes place whenever epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2. And whenever epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2, sin theta 1 is greater than epsilon 2 by epsilon 1, in both the formulas, rendu chotla kuda idi complex numbers lo untundi. So if you are taking this complex numbers magnitude, it is becoming 1. So ER by EI is becoming 1. ER by EI is equal to 1 means what does it mean? ER is equal to EI. That means what is the meaning of this? Whatever the incidenting, that entire thing will be reflecting, nothing will be transmitting like this. So the thing is, total internal reflection takes place whenever epsilon 1 is very, very greater than epsilon 2. And whatever the wave that is supported by this one is called as a surface wave. And the wave that is actually transmitting very slowly in the second medium is having a very less velocity, which can be called as a slow wave. So it is the surface wave is the best example of your non-uniform plane wave. I hope you understood the concept of your total internal reflection. Okay.